celebrated throughout the day, Holly. Here's Foster now, coming all the way around, swinging and getting loose into open space, Robert Foster.
Yeah, one of the things Brian Daboll has added to this offense is the threat of the jet sweep. A lot of times it's just there as eye candy just to get the linebacker's eyes off of different things. That time they fake the sweep, fake the inside run, and then through the swing pass out to Foster for a nice gain on the play.
On-time NFL assistant and offensive coordinator Brian Daboll, now his first year as the play caller here for Coach Saban. Hurts, first down pass, and once again, Josh Jacobs, similar to what they did for the touchdown strike not long ago.
A really nice job by Hurts getting rid of the football under duress. Victor Evans, the defensive end, was right there, and Hurts had to hang in under pressure and deliver the football, and he made an accurate throw. His decision-making, Joe, he is so calm, and he plays with such poise. Nothing flusters him. And I just think he has stepped up his game in terms of his knowledge of the offense.
Scarborough bounces off a would-be tackler and muscles his way inside the five. The flag is down. We will check on that.
Holding. 82 offense. 10-yard penalty. First down.
So tight end Irv Smith Jr. with the holding penalty. Haven't been too many mistakes by this Alabama offense. Here he is on the end of the line, number 82. Starts off in good position, but as he feels his man get away from him, kind of grabs a jersey right there. He had his hands in good position to start the block, but as Haynes tried to separate, he grabbed the jersey, and that's what drew the flag.
It back to the 24-yard line. First and 20 after the penalty. And this time, Scarborough met and then pushed down as Freeland Speaks was involved.
Talked about Brian Daboll. His first association with Nick Saban was as a GA at Michigan State back in the late 90s. And the other GAs on that staff at the time, Josh McDaniel, his best friend, who is the coordinator for the New England Patriots, Mel Tucker, who we met last week, is the defensive coordinator in Georgia, and Adam Gase, who's the head coach of the Miami Dolphins. That's a pretty good set of GAs to break in under Nick Saban.
Second and 19. See what Daboll comes up with here as he was looking to set up the screen to start. Listen, when your resume has Saban Foundation and then the rings with Belichick, you've had a pretty good career.
Yeah, and Parcells mixed in there as well. You know, a little bit of all of those guys.
Daboll was with the Browns, the Dolphins, the Chiefs. Of course, the Super Bowl wins with the Patriots for a decade up in New England. Now down here, he says, listen, I'm really enjoying Tuscaloosa, as is his wife, Beth, and congratulations to the Daboll's as they welcomed a two-week-old son, Luke. Their oldest is 18, and then there's little Luke,
number six.
Third and 19. Hurts extending the play. Rifled that thing into the end zone to Ruggs, who couldn't haul it in, and a flag comes in late. And as he was slow to get up,
Hurts did a beautiful job of keeping his eyes downfield as he scrambled. As good of a runner as he is, the team's leading rusher coming into the ballgame, he knew they needed long yardage after the penalty, and he stayed in there to throw it.
First
and made a beautiful throw.
Targeting. 23 defense. Does have the distance to the goal line. Automatic first down. This play is now under video review.
And that's Breon Dixon, who they say targeted Henry Ruggs there.
You see Hurts eluding the pressure. Eyes downfield, gets his shoulder square, rolling to his left. Should have been caught for a touchdown. I'm not sure how you call this targeting. The receiver was going down to the ground after the miss. He did kind of come in with his head, but he didn't hit him with his head.
Bill Lamagne is our rules expert. Bill, do we have forcible contact there?
Well, you hit the kid. key word there. He does have some contact to the head neck area. However, I would not deem that forcible contact, and I would expect the replay official to reverse this, and there'll be no penalty whatsoever.
I mean, the formula is...